Well, look, I started PubMatic along with my co-founders in part because it was a very disruptive, innovative idea, right? If you go back 15 years ago, 2006, there were no sell-side platforms. You know, that wasn't a term that existed. But I felt strongly that there was a big opportunity to create a multi-billion-dollar technology company focused on the needs of premium publishers. And that's exactly what we've done. I recall that I think it was the first 20 or so investors that I pitched, they declined to invest in PubMatic. And while, you know, people might feel negatively about that, I actually felt quite positive. And the reason for that is that I knew I was onto something that was unique, and there would not be, you know, dozens of kind of copycat companies following behind me because investors didn't really understand the concept or the opportunity. And so that, I think, is an important thing. You know, I have done startups in the past, you know, raised a lot of money in prior companies. So I've kind of been through that process before. And I think there's a lot of value to having a contrarian play that maybe not everybody understands, because it gives you a lot of breathing room in terms of the execution. Yeah, I think maybe two important lessons that I've learned along the way. The first is not to raise too much capital. And I see a lot of that mistake these days. I'm not referring specifically to ad tech, but let's say across technology in general. You know, you see these huge raises of $200, $300, $400 million. Sometimes they're warranted, but in many cases, it's before the company has figured out its kind of core unit economics and things like that. And that's a real danger, because if you don't grow into that valuation that's implied by that level of fundraise, or if there's an economic cycle between now and your next fundraise, that can be a real handicap where now the company may not be able to raise any more money. And that's the kind of thing that, you know, can put you out of business. So I think it's really important to be clear on how much you're raising and why. At PubMatic, we have been, I would say, remarkably capital efficient. So we raised somewhere in the ballpark of about $60 million prior to our IPO. And that's a really efficient amount of money to have raised, you know, to now be worth a couple billion dollars in the public markets. The second lesson I think that's important is really to focus on the individual at the VC firm, maybe even more so than the firm itself. So oftentimes entrepreneurs get caught up in, okay, I want to get a term sheet from this firm or from that firm because that firm has a great reputation. But in reality, you're going to be working with an individual, a partner who's going to be on your board, and she or he, their job is to represent, you know, the quality of investment to the rest of the partners in case there's follow-on investments or, you know, time that has to be spent to help move things forward. And so it's really important that you focus, I think, on who is that person rather than who is the firm, because it's really the person that the entrepreneur is getting married to.
So Rajeev, we've seen a lot of changes in ad tech. Some great companies come along and many sort of vanishing and going away. When you think about this resilience of PubMatic over all these years, like, what are some key ingredients for your growth and your success?
Yeah, I think there's a couple of key ingredients that I'd call out. The first is our focus on team and on culture. So we've built, I think, at PubMatic, a very transparent, team-oriented culture. We share a lot of information with our employees, whether it's, you know, good news or maybe not so good news. We bring everybody into the decision-making process to the extent possible. So we explain not only what decisions might be, but why we're doing those decisions. And we really think about how do we make PubMatic the best place for any potential candidate or employee to spend, you know, several years of their career journey at PubMatic. And I think that focus on team and culture has created, you know, really strong retention, really strong engagement, and a high performance environment. So I think that's certainly one key. Second key to success that we've been able to demonstrate over, you know, many years now is to really have a differentiated approach to the industry. So we really focus on the industry from an infrastructure perspective, you know, having the most efficient and the highest quality infrastructure in the ecosystem. And that's a pretty unique approach to digital advertising and certainly to the sell side portion of the ecosystem than many others that are out there. And we've been able to, I think, build a pretty significant competitive moat as a result of that. And then the third is that, you know, we never rest with the success that we've seen. We recognize that, you know, digital advertising, advertisers, agencies, they have choice as to where they spend money. Publishers have choice as to who they work with. And so we need to keep pushing ourselves to innovate as rapidly as possible. And so I myself spend a lot of time on innovation. We have, you know, obviously great product managers, engineers across the organization. And we're constantly pushing ourselves to think about how can we build new solutions for our customers? How can we do better? How can we service them better? And really earn their business on a day in and day out basis.
So, Rajeev, we've been speaking to a number of entrepreneurs who have done exits or, you know, liquidity events or however you want to call it. Some going the SPAC way, some going through private equity, some through strategic sales. You went through an IPO. Tell us about, you know, how you evaluated the IPO, the public markets versus the private markets, and why it made sense for PubMatic.
Yeah, one of my focus areas as the CEO of the company for quite a while now, many years, has been to build a standalone profitable business so that we could control our own destiny. And I think no secret to the audience that, may be watching this, you know, the advertising technology space has gone hot and cold from an investor perspective, you know, over the last decade or so. And so I felt strongly that, you know, we needed to be profitable. We needed to be able to control our own destiny and not be reliant on outside investment. And so in fact, you know, prior to the IPO, our last round of financing was in 2012, 2013. So, you know, we were able to live on the cash that we raised then for 7 or 8 years. And so I think by focusing on having a great profitable standalone business, it opened up a lot of different options for us, right? Whether it's to stay private, to go public, to, you know, pursue a private equity combination or a strategic acquirer. And so that, you know, flexibility has obviously served us well. One of the challenges in the category is that I think strategic acquirers really have a hard time understanding many of the companies in this category. And the reason for that is that the strategics tend to be more on the media or publishing content side of things and less so in the technology arena. And at its core, obviously, advertising technology is about technology. And so it takes, a certain type of strategic acquirer that really understands that technology. And that's, you know, that's not extremely common. And now I think one of the benefits that we see of being public is that, you know, we're doing deals with very large partners in the ecosystem. So agencies, advertisers, publishers, and being public, you know, gives us a level of transparency that creates confidence with those partners to build for the future and to build their business on top of our platform.